Clutch means me getting it done. I'm happy for being considered one of the clutch players in the game because that lets me know that I got the job done no matter what.
He does it all the time. He's really sneaky about it. And he does it. It's not like once in a while. It's consistent. He did it last year in the finals. He's done it for us all regular season long. And he's going to keep on doing it. And, you know, that's Robert.
Drafted by Houston in 1992, Robert Horry was looked to for energy and athleticism.
Big move now to Horry in for the right. No! Oh, what a miss by Robert Horry! An explosion!
And by 94, he was playing a pivotal role in the finals against the Knicks.
Oh, Robert Horry with a three!
Houston won the title, and in the playoffs the next year, Robert came up big once again.
The shot I made against San Antonio when I was in Houston. You know, I was 0 for 9 the whole game, and then I got the ball and made a shot in that sealed the game.
All along, Horry, good. With a lead with 6.5 seconds.
Horry helped propel the Rockets to their second straight finals, but opponents still didn't realize just how dangerous he could be.
When I started my career, you know, people would back off me. You know, let him shoot, he can't shoot.
And Robert would make them all regret it, including the Orlando Magic in the... On to Los Angeles in 1997, he would add to his reputation as a clutch performer. In Game 3 of the 2002 playoffs against Portland, the Lakers trailed with seconds remaining.
Well, the play was designed to come in and get the ball to Kobe in the middle of the floor. The ball was inbounded. He got it at the top of the key, and they had the so-called Kobe stopper on him and Rubin, so...
Kobe calls for it. He has it against Rubin Patterson, the Kobe stopper.
Everybody cleared out, went to their favorite spots. I went to the right corner. You know, Kobe got it down to 5, 4, 3, and he started penetrating.
Bryant, dishing off, Horry, for three, got it!
I just caught it, looked at it, got it on the scene, shot it. See, I did this on him like, yeah, baby, we out of here, let's go home.
And in the Western Conference Finals against the Kings, Horry would provide one of the most dramatic moments in playoff history.
Now Horry out front, 10 seconds, Kobe Bryant against Christie. Kobe Bryant on the move against Christie, in for the right, flips his shot up, no good. O'Neal lays it up, missed it. Ball tipped out to Horry, a straight on three, good! Horry's greatest hits tour continues.
I think a lot of us on the bench were trying to figure out if the ball had really gone in. We were trying to figure out if the clock had expired, if his foot was on the line, but it was another classic Robert Horry finish.
The Kings were deflated, and like all of Robert's other victims, they could only shake their heads in frustration.
Everybody could make that shot, you know, that's last shot. It's just lucky shot, that's all. You don't need to have a skills or some, you know, in that kind of situation. You just throw it and if it goes in, goes in.
Robert, Vlade was saying that it was basically just a luck shot, that situation, you just have to throw it up. Was it luck or was there more to it?
It wasn't no luck shot. I've been doing that for all my career, so he should know. He better read a paper or something.
Robert won 3 championship rings in Los Angeles, bringing his total to 5. And by now, opponents had learned the hard way not to leave him open.
Now when you're coming down to a game-type situation, guys on the court say, don't leave Rob. You know, that's the first thing out of their mouth is don't leave Rob.
Top 3, I'd say. Michael Jordan, Larry Bird, and Robert Horry, and clutch shots, man. And if I'm on them, I'm just not leaving them. Shaq can have an open dunk. Kobe can have an open dunk. I'm not leaving you. Not leaving you.
In 2003, with the Lakers and Spurs tied at 2 in the conference semifinals, Horry was in a familiar position.
Shaq up high, played by Robinson. Down to 10. Bryant
shake-off bullet. Here's Horry for three. Robinson with the rebound that was in and out.
Kobe Bryant kicks it out to an open Robert Horry. Watch this ball. It is halfway in and back out again.
The Spurs went on to win the series and the championship. And for once, Robert had to cope with the bitter taste of failure.
Being known for being a guy who shows up in the playoffs, it's like my show didn't open this playoff. So, you know, it was tough, but, you know, you got to keep your head up and get yourself right for next year.
But the next year would find him in a new home. Robert joined the Lakers' rivals, the Spurs, and he instantly fit in.
Hey, Robert Aria, how do you like that black and white jersey? You like it?
I like it a lot, man. Okay. I should have had this on a long time ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
He's made a lot more clutch shots than he's missed, but through it all, his mindset hasn't changed.
You got to have I don't care attitude. You gotta go out there and just play. Whatever happens, happens. You can't control anything. You can just do your best at what you do. And a lot of times people worry, I got to make this. I don't even think that way. If I make it, I make it. If I don't, oh well.
In the 2005 finals, the Spurs and Pistons were tied at two games apiece, fighting for control of the series.
This is fraught with tension and apprehension.
I mean, it's the biggest possession I can remember in a long, long time.
You wear the slip. No three-point play.
Horry will throw in. Player who throws in is frequently the player for whom the play is run. He comes in on the bounce to Ginobili. Back to Horry. He shoots the three. Oh, my goodness. Robert Horry hitting a three on the left wing with 5.8 left. And the Spurs take a one-point lead.
And big shot Bob did it again.
I can't believe that the man can do it anymore. How many bullets does he have left in that gun?
As the ball came back to Robert, he had a look on his face that he could not believe that Rasheed Wallace had left him at that point and almost had a smirk on his face like, you're going to leave me open?
And though the Pistons still had time for a final shot, Horry had already written the ending.
Prince looking inside, finds Hamilton posting up on Parker. Ball knocked away, got it back, puts up the shot, no good. Rebound tipped out front, grabbed by Bowen. This ball game is over. The Spurs have won game five.
Yeah. I'll tell you the deal with Rob. Rob just hangs out the entire game. He does it all season long. He doesn't do anything. He doesn't feel like playing. He shows up sometimes. And then you put him in a fourth quarter in a big game, and he's like, okay, it's time to play now. I've been hanging out the entire season. It's time to play now. And he just turns it on. And as funny as that seems, it's just how it is. He doesn't want to show up. He doesn't feel like playing until it's a big game.
Thank you. Robert Horry will be next.
Horry earned his sixth ring, becoming just the second player to win a title with three different teams. But to Robert, there's more to his legacy than winning.
Phil Jackson gives out a test, and he says the three words you want to be remembered by. And I said, he had fun. So that's how I want to be remembered. He had fun. You know, I'm always on the court smiling, laughing. No matter if we up or down, I'm going to enjoy myself. And I just want people to realize just he had fun.